Two beautiful minds. Today we have Shweta joining us, and Shweta is a yoga teacher, and she's also Mrs. Telangana, India Telangana 2022. To welcome to our show, Shweta, how are you doing?
Welcome, Madeline ji, and good evening to everyone. I'm fine, thank you. Hope you are also doing good. So, Sir Shweta Mangalore from Hyderabad. I'm a yoga teacher by profession, and I have bestowed with like Mrs. Charming Telangana and Mrs. India Telangana 2022.
That's wonderful. Congratulations on that. So we would like to hear
Thank you so
more
much.
about you. So I would like you to go ahead and tell us about your journey.
Okay, sure. Basically, the Shweta which you are seeing me today is completely different the one which I was in my childhood. I was a very shy person and got married in at very early age due to the sad demise of my father. But I always had a dream of doing something different, creating a unique identity for myself. To do something for this society, you know, I used to get admired by the people to give back to the society, work for this society. I never got fascinated or admired by the celebrities or anyone, but I used to get admired by models. So I had the dream of doing some to contribute to this and for the betterment of the society. Dream was not full. Then once I was and I had two once I met my husband's friend who attended one of my family's function. There I happened to meet her and I came to know that she has participated in Mrs. India Telangana. By the time I was a yoga coach, everything was fine, but still my desire was not fulfilled. So then I thought, let even try that once, because nowadays I see the concept of beauty pageants have evolved completely. They used to pick the pageants or the contestants based on the physical attributes. Now it's good to see the involvement happening in the beauty pageants where they give importance to the role models. They give their preference to the inner beauty, you know, their talent and potential of executing in uncertain conditions. So I love this concept, you know. I just tried and went off. In the year 2020, I have participated and bestowed the title of Mrs. Charming. And again in 2022, I have won the main title winner as Mrs. India Telangana 2020. So that's it.
So how was your experience? How did you feel?
Great. That's what in the matter. You can see the better version of myself. More confident, Shweta, a more hidden talent. The talent was hidden in me. I could execute it. You know, the way they have groomed us, the way they have put us into uncertain conditions and best in those conditions, groomed us very well. We have been the better version of ourselves. A person.
Okay, so now are you inspired by Baba Ramdev Garu also? Because
Yes,
I
before
just
I take this, yes, before I take this yoga as a professional coach, before doing completing my teacher training course, I used to practice yoga in my childhood. You know, I went to several camps like Shri Shri Yoga Vishankar Ji, Baba Ramdev's. During my gestation period, also I used to practice some light warm-ups and Anulom Vilom Nadi Shodhan Pranayam. But after delivering, I thought of doing something, you know, to mingle with this society. Then I just completed my training course under the guidance of Manas sir. I was very much fascinated and admired by Baba Ramdev. So I just loved his concept, you know, of teaching yoga, making it simplified. And I'm very proud that I'm continuing my Indian culture and teaching my preachings, which are very helpful to my students.
So how do you think that practicing yoga benefited your life?
Definitely, because during my second pregnancy, I had a breast complication which is known as a DVD. This is a ailment which doctor usually say that once in a lakh people suffer this. I was completely unaware of this, so I was like completely, you know, doctors have asked me to terminate my pregnancy. You know, we had many. I was not only physically depressed, but I also had mental ailments. With the grace of God and under the guidance of a very good doctor, of course, I delivered, but the changes, the steroids which I took, whatever body just my body have gone through, doctors were completely suggested me that you can never recover in your life. The baby gets abort itself if you are continuing your pregnancy. But with my will and with my knowledge of whatever I had, I just did it everything, you know. So I thought that let me implement this knowledge to this society. So I just went for the certification and I started my journey yoga.
What type of yogas do you teach? Shweta,
I teach kind of yogas, madam. So basically, have three categories. You know, we start with the beginner's level. So now, can you hear me, ma'am?
Yes.
Is it audible?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So basically, we have the three classifications in yoga. We start with the basic level, that is beginner's level. Once you have mastered in beginner's level, then you will be shifted to intermediate and advanced level depending upon your flexibility and your performance in the class.
Okay. So what do you suggest, you know, to the young generation, especially ladies, for, you know, to lead a healthy lifestyle?
Yes, definitely. Because since many people follow our culture, so what is wrong to not to follow our culture? Since yoga has brought a great transformation in my physical and mental ailment, I suggest everyone to keep practice yoga, have a disciplined life, control on your diet, and maintain it as a routine in your life. Definitely, you will observe the differences, not only physically, but also mentally. You can harmonize, balance all the aspects of your body, mind, and emotions.
Okay. Now, since right now you are a very successful person, and also I want to know, like, how do you define success in your life?
For me, success is not a full stop, you know. The life is all about a beautiful journey, you know. You have to struggle throughout your life. You know, many people congratulated me on my success. I then just convinced myself somewhere, I feel that just now I have started my journey. Life is all about a beautiful struggle, you know. If you have owned this title, this is not the end of your journey. Your journey has started because many people started emulating you as a role model. You have to bring changes in your behavior, your performance, because you're going to be the role model to several people, especially children and young generation. So I always define success, it's not a specific meaning for success, you know. Whatever you have a passion inside you, try to own it constantly, then prove you are 100% efficiently, then you can give a proper word success.
Okay. So when you were about to, you know, go and join the beauty pageant, and also how did your family support you, or did you have any kind of issues that you faced?
No, absolutely not. Because see, it's not that they did not support me. I come from a very conservative family, you know, middle class family. We are all settled, you know, we have very good bungalows and cars and all, you know. The first thing was, I did not reveal them until I was a finalist. So why did I reveal? Because the year which I have registered, that was a pandemic year.
Okay.
I needed someone to take my pics and videos and submit to the organization. So
yeah.
There I was forcefully supposed to intimate my family members because I needed someone to take the pics and the videos. Because okay. I was very much scared, you know, because they are very possessive regarding me. You know, they have some misconceptions, you know, these people, how are pageants, you know, how do they do with you? You know, they may misuse you. I can absolutely understand. But in spite of all the obstacles, yes. So I never defended or offended them. I just kept quiet myself, kept calm. I thought that let me prove once, then I'll just come back and convince everyone and make them, everyone happy. And that's what is happening now. Everyone is proud of me.
That's wonderful to know. So Shweta, apart from all this, like, what is your biggest fear?
Nothing as such. Nothing as such. Earlier, I used to, you know, I was in dilemma, you know, when you give multiple tasks, I was a bit low confident guy, you know, very shy person to face the camera and all, you know. But I used to think that how could I manage with family, multiple tasks, how could I go there and execute? But now, since we have been given so much of exposure and so much of grooming, now I can handle multiple tasks and plan properly and execute my things properly. That is the biggest transformation that I can see in myself.
Okay, that's really nice to know. So where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? Like, what are your future goals?
Okay, future goals are much more, because I have just now bestowed the title, and in the upcoming events we also have for national levels, wherein I have to compete with the other contestants who are coming throughout all the states from India. So that is the next level. And I also have a dream of opening a fitness institute, wherein I can offer my knowledge or share my knowledge for the underprivileged people and the people who cannot come to the classes. So I am planning to open some institute where everybody can come and do yoga, at least for a few days or few this thing. Those who cannot offer, those who cannot come to the classes. So I just want to help.
So like how many times per week do you think that we should practice yoga?
Daily. There is no such rules. Daily you have to practice. It's better you practice daily.
Okay. So what are some of your favorite yoga poses since you are into yoga?
Headstand, Shirshasana, headstand, standing Chakrasana. Okay, Dhanurasana, all are my favorite, and pranayama is my favorite because we do so many things, you know, we execute so many things. Due to time management, we are so much stressed. So at night I just sit to my bed and just relax by taking some deep breaths. So pranayama and meditation are my favorite part.
Okay, so you are also doing something for social cause, right? So what are the other things that you have been doing in life?
Okay, so as I said you that in the year 2020, I have registered for Mrs. India Telangana, who is Mamta Trivedi ma'am is the regional director of that. So after owing the title of Mrs. Charming, Mamta ma'am has an NGO called Seva. Okay, so that Seva is working for the betterment of the society and several social causes. You know, she's a wonderful lady who has been contributing for the society. So under her guidance and some of the other family members from Mrs. India Telangana, we have done several like handlooms, empowerment of girl child, you know, and how to save your girl child from sexual abuse, and conserving and preserving natural resources. So like that, the process is going on, you know, there is no such full stop as such.
Okay. So you know, while practicing yoga, since many are doing, you know, these days they are concentrating more on yoga. So I would like to know, like, while practicing yoga, okay, mm-hmm. how do you stay focused on your breathing?
Okay. So that's a typical question. Okay. So first of all, to be frank, you cannot focus, as we all are human beings. Our mind will be definitely cluttering here and there. Okay, so do not worry, sit and start meditating on any one object, either it may be a candle flame or your own breath. At that time, if any unnecessary thoughts are cluttering, do not try to control it forcefully. Let them come and flow freely. Again, shift your concentration back on your breath. As and when you practice regularly, definitely one day you will be able to focus, attain the stage of calm and mindfulness. This is what I can say to you.
That's really true, actually, you know, when we cannot focus continually, so we keep getting diverted.
We do have many varieties of meditation, you know, those who cannot concentrate by their own, we have guided meditation, we have music sound meditation, so you can go for those things, those who are unable to concentrate by themselves.
Okay, so I have one tricky question for you. So, okay. You know, what is one rule that you think you would like to break?
Break?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. One rule which I would like to break is the dowry system. Dowry system. if I would have chief minister or anything, not necessary to be any chief minister or something, I would definitely like to break the dowry system, and men should be equally treated as men in the society.
So Shweta, what makes you different from the other contestants?
See, everybody is good in their own field, okay? It's not like different, but I appreciate myself because in spite of facing many obstacles, I failed many times. I have fallen many times. It is not that I have achieved everything in overnight, you know. I have worked for this. Now many people sit in front of TV, if they watch me, many people, you know, emulate me as a role model, or they may admire me, but only I know what effort I have put to come at this stage. So the hard work, in spite of falling many times but coming back and performing more than the previous attempts, that makes me unique, I feel, and always have a keen of learning and exploring new things. That is what I feel, it makes me unique.
Good one. So Shweta, anything else that you know you would like to tell to our audience who are watching the show?
Definitely. As we have been seeing recently that the whole world has been affected badly due to pandemic. You know, this condition may appear anytime. So do not wait for those conditions. Always keep yourself fit and fine, not only physically but also mentally. So keep practicing yoga, stay healthy, stay have proper balanced diet. Okay, because I believe a healthy body and a healthy mind is a key for success. So that is what I would like to suggest for all.
Okay, and so one last question from my side. If you were granted one wish, okay, what wish would that be?
What wish would it be? Right now, what strikes my mind is to be a national winner and make my country proud.
Well, absolutely. Someday that will be fulfilled. Thank you so much, Shweta. It was really wonderful talking to you. So anybody wants to get connected with you, so do you teach offline or online? How is it like?
No, I'm teaching both offline as well as physically. I've started because as we are now, we are been recovering from the pandemic situation, started physical classes also, online classes also, wherein people residing out of India also get connected to me.
Okay, great. So you can share all your social handlings with us so that we can, you know, post it on our page and people can get in touch with you. So it was really wonderful to get in touch with you, and congratulations for all your success that you had in this during this pandemic especially. Thank you so much for coming on our show, and you have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Edlinji, for inviting me. I have been watching your shows. It keeps us motivating, you know, when we listen the inspiring speeches from many ladies, it keeps us inspiring and motivating. So thank you for the wonderful show, and thank you for inviting me. Thank you so much.
Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Same here. Bye.
Friends, have a great evening. Bye-bye.